Well, local law enforcement officers made a felony arrest earlier this week, and during that, a dog was shot and killed. Now, Monday afternoon, the Inyo County Sheriff's Department responded to the 300 block of South Paha Lane in Bishop to contact Raymond Denver, a 42-year-old man who was wanted for kidnapping, vandalism, and battery. Now, according to a press release from the Inyo County Sheriff's Office, as the sheriff's deputy and tribal police were approaching Raymond Denver, an extremely aggressive dog advanced from behind the residence and attempted to bite the sheriff's deputy. Now, in an effort to protect himself, the deputy fired one shot at the dog. Animal control responded and transported the animal to a veterinarian where it expired from the gunshot wound. Raymond Denver was taken into custody without further incident and is currently being held at the Inyo County Jail in Independence under the felony charges. Bail has been set for $250,000. Well, here's a great story about a bald eagle in the Eastern Sierra that had fallen out of a tree last week in Mono County. Now, Mike Aguirre brought the baby bald eagle to Eastern Sierra Wildlife Care, where Cindy Kamler and crew checked it out. Kamler said it was her first time in rescuing a bald eagle, and there was limited time to get the baby bird back to near its parents. Now, last Thursday, July 3rd, Mike Aguirre, with the help of Kevin Calder and BZ Miller, created a makeshift platform in a suitable tree about 100 yards away from the nesting tree, and that was the tree from which the young eagle fell. Now, the nesting tree was too high and impossible to get to with a lift, so after placing the eagle on the platform about 30 feet off the ground, the three men quickly withdrew from the area, and the young eagle was in clear view of the parents, who were watching them the entire time. Now, a neighbor who had a view of the tree said later that the young eagle sat on the platform all day Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, but there was no sighting of the parents going to the young bird. Now, on Sunday morning, Mike Aguirre went back to the location only to find that the bird was no longer on the platform. He proceeded to walk the area, wondering if a predator had gotten to the bird. As he walked further away from the tree and up a rocky knoll, the parents soon appeared, flying and soaring above him and vocalizing what was probably warning sounds. Now, a few minutes later, Mike Aguirre spotted the younger eagle perched on a nearby rock about 20 feet from him. He slowly backed up and left the area. Now, the initial goal, which was set in place by Cindy Kamler and Eastern Sierra Wildlife Care, was to reestablish contact with the parents, which is what happened. Mike Aguirre said, quote, "It was an amazing thing. I'm still pinching myself that I got to be a part of that rescue. And being around the 4th of July made it especially patriotic. Now it's in nature's hands." Now, Aguirre offered many thanks to Eastern Sierra Wildlife Care and the work they do. And he said, if you would like to make a donation, you can visit their website, eswildlifecare.org. Now, Aguirre also offered some more personal stories, including how he touched the young bird's head and then started petting him. Aguirre said the bird just sat there, didn't flinch or spook. He just sat there and let Aguirre pet him. He would blink his eyes with each stroke, and Aguirre said he couldn't believe that he was petting a bald eagle in his house, noting the bird never once tried to bite him or showed any aggression. Now, Aguirre also said he was thinking how cool it would be to walk out of his house someday after he and maybe now his white feathered head, and there he'd be perched on his roof with a fish in his claw, and then tossing Aguirre the fish and saying, "Hey kid, thanks a lot." You know, there's a lot more information and insights from Mike Aguirre on our website, sierrawave.net. We urge you to check that out, and we thank Mike Aguirre for the information, and congratulations on a great story. Well, one of the tasty events in the Eastern Sierra takes place this weekend, the Mammoth Lakes Foundation's Mammoth Food and Wine Experience. Sierra Wave Media's Rob Gill talked with Juliana Olinka about the mouthwatering festivities.
You may have noticed there are a few tents around here on the Mammoth Lakes Foundation property because we're getting ready for the Mammoth Food and Wine Experience. The event starts actually Thursday night with a free screening in the village at Mammoth of a movie called Somme, all about what it takes to become a sommelier, and you'll learn so much about wine. It's a fabulous movie. I really enjoyed it. Then Friday morning, we have the best of the best burger battle. The 405 versus the 395. Three local chefs against an LA chef. And the winner gets to go to the World Food Championships in Las Vegas in November. We've got food and wine seminars on Friday and Saturday. Some of them are just, actually all of them are amazing. You owe it to yourself to come to one of those. And everything during this event is a la carte. $20 for seminars. The burger battle's $35 a person. We have a wine walk in the village on Friday night with 16 wineries pouring a lot of wine for you to taste. And the village is going to have the Spasmatics doing an 80s retrospective music background against the wine walk. We also have some fabulous dinners. And then Saturday night's the grand tasting. In honor of the 25th anniversary of the Mammoth Lakes Foundation, we have 25 wineries pouring over 100 wines, live auctions, silent auction, some really great live auction prizes, by the way. If you want to go to the Indy 500, you want to be here on Saturday night. Tickets are $140 online for the grand tasting, $150 at the door. To buy tickets or to get more information, visit mammothfoodandwine.org. Hope to see you Friday, Saturday, or even at the screening on Thursday night.
Tickets and information for the Mammoth Food and Wine Experience available on the website, mammothfoodandwine.org. We'll be back with more from the Mammoth Lakes 4th of July Parade.